Hello guys, this is Indian Medico and in this video we are going to see about Phyllodes tumour. This is a concise presentation for medical students. The term Phyllodes literally means leaf-like. It is called so because of its histological appearance. We will be seeing about the histological appearance of Phyllodes tumour in the upcoming slides. Phyllodes tumour is also known as Cystosarcoma Phyllodes or Serocystic disease of Brody. It is typically a large, fast-growing mass that forms from the periductal stromal cells of the breast. It accounts for less than 1% of all breast neoplasms. So, it is relatively a rare condition. It is a fibroepithelial tumour, which means that there are both epithelial and cellular stromal components. The term fibro denotes the stromal components and the term epithelial denotes the epithelial components. Phyllodes tumour contains both these components. Phyllodes tumour is mostly a benign tumour. However, it can be divided into three types depending on the malignancy. They are benign, borderline and malignant. We can call a Phyllodes tumour as borderline or malignant depending upon the mitotic activity, cellularity and infiltration at the edge of the tumour. But remember, Phyllodes tumour are mostly benign. This picture shows a Phyllodes tumour. The patient has a Phyllodes tumour on her right breast. Now let us see about the clinical features of Phyllodes tumour. Phyllodes tumour usually occur over the age of 40 years. They can appear in younger women also, but the most common age of presentation is over 40 years prior to menopause. It is a large tumour as you can see from the picture. It has a bosselated surface. Since it is a very large tumour, the skin over the tumour will be stretched and shiny, and you can make out dilated veins over the surface. And it feels warm to touch. Remember, Phyllodes tumour shows rapid growth. Since it shows rapid growth, there will be necrosis in various places. This causes cystic areas within the breast and there will be serous fluid discharge. Now, how do you differentiate Phyllodes tumour from carcinoma of breast? Phyllodes tumour has no fixity to the skin. It has no fixity to the pectoralis, that is, it will be mobile on the chest wall. There will be no lymph node involvement and no nipple retraction in case of Phyllodes. How do you diagnose Phyllodes tumour? It is basically a clinical diagnosis. You can do ultrasonography to confirm the size of the tumour and to find out solid and cystic areas. True cut biopsy can be done. Histology reveals branching pattern penetrating the cystic cavity. Remember, I told you Phyllodes literally means leaf-like. It is called so because of this branching pattern which resembles leaf. In case of benign Phyllodes tumour, it will resemble a fibroadenoma, whereas malignant Phyllodes tumour show mitotic figures. This picture shows the histology of Phyllodes tumour. Note the characteristic long clefts and myxoid cellular stroma. Now let us see about the treatment of Phyllodes tumour. If a young woman has benign Phyllodes tumour, you can try enucleation. However, the treatment of choice for a small benign Phyllodes tumour is wide excision with 1 to 2 cm margin. For a massive Phyllodes tumour, you can do a wider excision or you can go for simple mastectomy. Simple mastectomy is also done for a case of recurrent Phyllodes tumour or malignant Phyllodes tumour. Remember, lumpectomy should never be done for a case of Phyllodes tumour because Phyllodes tumour recurs after lumpectomy. Now let us see about the complications of Phyllodes tumour. If Phyllodes tumour is not treated properly, it can lead to pressure necrosis and can cause ulceration of overlying skin and secondary infection. There can be distant metastatic spread in case of malignant Phyllodes tumour The metastasis occurs via the bloodstream and can involve lungs and long bones. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe, and tell your friends about this channel. Thank you.